tell me about this company, because the reason on your show is that you have this big moment. A satellite is built and it's moving from just down the road from where we're sitting now to Florida. Why?
Yeah, thanks for having me here on the show. So at Astranis, we built a new kind of satellite. So this is a microsatellite for higher orbits, starting with a special orbit called geostationary orbit. So this is an orbit where we can put a satellite up into space and basically park it over a country, providing continuous service with just that one satellite. So that allows us to provide service at very low cost compared to other types of satellite applications compared to certainly the old school satellites that have come before. So today is a big day for us because we're launching our, we just shipped our first satellite out the door. It is arriving at Cape Canaveral as we speak. And there it's going to be integrated onto a SpaceX rocket for its ride to space.
We're just showing those pictures on the screen of it being loaded into the container, back of a big rig, and off it goes. How does it get to space?
We're going to be riding as a rideshare on a Falcon Heavy rocket. So this is a big rocket.
Is there a date set?
Yes, SpaceX is looking at the week of April 8th. So we've got a launch window. We'll have a more definitive date as we get a little bit closer. Yeah.
And in this instance, this is a satellite that will provide capability for a commercial customer, a private sector customer, right?
Yeah, that's right. So we have a private customer in the U.S. state of Alaska called Pacific Dataport. They're an internet service provider there. We specialize at Astranis in providing trunking and backhaul capacity, so more for enterprise customers and ISPs. And this will actually be the first time that the state of Alaska has had a satellite dedicated just for them. So the satellite is not it's not trying to cover all of the U.S. It's not trying to cover all of North America. It's actually just dedicated for that area of Alaska and our customer there. And that's what we do at Astranis. We put up dedicated satellites for our customers and provide really broad, really low-cost broadband communications.
John, $1.4 billion valuation in your last round, and you have some big-name backers. They clearly see potential in your business. This is just one satellite, but is this revenue generating? Does this mark sort of a substantive step forward for the business side of what you're doing?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is a fantastic proof point for us, obviously. This is our first satellite that will be generating substantial revenue and recurring revenue on a services basis, which is okay. What we do.
Like a subscription, or what is the model for you? I mean, long term, how do you make money based on the satellites that you're building?
Yeah, we put up these satellites, we own and operate them, and we lease capacity. So gigabits a second on an ongoing lease basis. So that's what we do for our customers, and we have projects like that in work all over the world. You asked about what might be coming next, and we have actually five satellites launching this year. This is just the first one, and then we're spooling up our satellite factory here in San Francisco as we speak to get to the point where we can build actually two satellites a month, which is a huge production scale for this type of satellite.
I want to get into production, but first, you talked about the kind of cadence of satellites you hope to deploy for the rest of the year. Are those SpaceX as well?
We have procured a dedicated launch on a SpaceX Falcon 9 for later this year for a four-pack of satellites. That'll be a first for us. It's the first time we've gotten a whole dedicated rocket just for us, so that'll be four of our satellites flying together on that, just us and nobody else. So first time we'll be moving away from a rideshare launch. And then for future launches, I guess we'll see from there.
Well, what was that experience like, you know, doing business with SpaceX? How far in advance did you have to commit to securing that Falcon 9 launch capacity?
Yeah, I mean, you typically buy these rockets pretty far in advance, a couple years in advance, although they've been very flexible with us. And I'd say, honestly, they've been a fantastic partner as this new piece of space infrastructure that's been opening up space for companies like ours and other applications all over the space ecosystem.
How much did it cost you to secure that Falcon 9?
Oh, I'm not going to go into pricing here, but SpaceX has, I think, you know, all things being equal, the rockets are incredibly affordable. Certainly, you look at what has come before, some of the old school rockets, you know, the Atlas and Delta rockets that came before SpaceX, they were unbelievably expensive,
right?
On just a dollars per kilo basis. So we found SpaceX to be incredibly affordable, and they've been a great partner for us. Yeah.
So that's one part of your business, servicing private sector customers. The other side is the public sector, right? And you have existing relationships with the DoD or the military.
Yeah.
How important is that to you, servicing what are basically public requirements for connectivity and satellite capacity?
Yeah, it's an incredibly important mission, and the world has changed. In just the last year, we saw a huge change in the global dynamic, and now we've realized just how important it is to be able to serve these national security needs. Just to give you one example, in the Ukraine, when the Russians invaded, one of the very first things they did, I think it was actually on day one of the invasion, is they launched a massive cyber attack against right. one of these very large geo satellites. And they took out this satellite in one fell swoop that was providing broadband comms all over Ukraine. So, when something like that happened, that was a real turning point, I think, in our industry. And it made the point of just how urgent a lot of this was for us to get better space infrastructure up and in place.
It sounds like there is demand for your satellites, and obviously your restriction is how quickly you can build them and deploy them into orbit. Is there a need to raise more funds to kind of bridge that gap, either privately or going to public markets?
Sure. I mean, we're heads down getting this first satellite up and getting that to be successful. Certainly, there'll be plenty of room to have that conversation later this year after we get that up and operating. That'll be a big moment for us.